Our great grandfather founded the company almost 110 years ago now, in 1907, right here in Winnipeg. General commercial printer, printed letterheads, business cards, whatever you wanted, and had a pretty successful career as a small little Winnipeg-based commercial printer. Our grandfather took it over from him in the 40s. Then our father took it over from his father in 1963. In the 70s, our father said, look, what is the future for commercial printing? And maybe we need to do something a little different or find a niche. And we had already started doing some security-related printing, so he really went into sort of security printing at the time in the 70s. He actually changed the name of the company to Pollard Banknote Limited back there in the late 70s because he really wanted to print paper currency. And he tried to get a contract from the Bank of Canada to do that. But along the way, government introduced the dollar coin, which put a big dent in the paper currency business, and lottery tickets, which was one of the things we'd started printing in the 70s, really started to take off in the late 70s and early 80s.
It would be hard for a new entrant to come into the business. What shows up is very high barriers to entry. It's first of all very capital intensive. So to actually create a production facility, you would spend, you know, probably $50 million by the time you had everything set up. Contracts don't come up all the time, right? So governments bid out their contracts every 3 to 5 years. And so you'd have to wait a while till they built up your work. But more important than that, the governments aren't really interested in taking a risk on a new supplier, because what ends up happening is the piece of lottery ticket that we sell to the lottery, we sell it for about a penny. They turn around and sell it for 25, you know, for a margin of 25 cents after you pay the, you know, $1 ticket pays the prizes and pays the retailer commissions. So the lotteries don't really want to save a fraction of a penny if it costs them potentially quarters. We're the second largest producer of scratch and win lottery tickets in the world, in an industry that's very hard to break into. And what the industry has shown is that even when recessions hit, the sales don't really drop off that much. There's still a degree of purchases that are impulse but are subject to discretionary income. So when a recession hits, sales might soften or growth might soften, but we haven't seen a shrinkage or a contraction of the business.